I want to stress on a political problem, which is the considerable distance which separates the strength of the struggles, I would call them the struggles rather than the movements, movements in struggle, the struggles, and the results, if we call them so, coming out of electoral processes. Now, I'll take one example because it's a striking example, the one of Egypt, but I think that that could be said also of other examples, such as France or Greece, with due respect to the specificities and differences, of course. Now, in Egypt, we had a gigantic popular movement in struggle with a variety, a lot have been written and analyzed, of the various social, political, ideological components of it, and the demands, which in some cases, or in many cases, were very concrete and radical. Radical in the sense that it could not be achieved unless you have a total change in the balance of force nationally and at the regional and perhaps even global level. And I'll come to that point later. You know, in a country even of 85 million people, when 15 million people are mobilized during 2 weeks, 24 hours, day and night, occupying the whole country, that's not a small thing. And those people were not just plagued by occupying with a few vague slogans. They had, many of them, but they are the minority in the country, in the society, but a strong a minority, which is the active minority, and that's very, very important. And then, what was the strategy of the reactionary forces and of the US? A strategy of let us have this transition as quick as possible, ending with elections. And we had elections. And the elections gave the result, as you know, that is 60% reactionary political Islam, the majority, and only 40% for representative, diluted representative of the struggles. Well, that's normal. It was expected. It was expected. Nothing abnormal. Because elections, the rule of the so-called rule of majority, means elections have always a very conservative dimension. It is preventing the minority of becoming the majority through the continuation and deepening of the struggles. I mean, when I say we, quite a number, but a large number of people in Egypt, we don't believe in what Lenin called in his time parliamentary cretinism. We don't believe that once a parliament has been elected, he puts set the rules and you have to play within the rules. No. Play within the rules and outside of the rules through struggles in order to, for what are the minority, but the minority which was the active minority mobilizing the whole country. Now, why was it so in the concrete case of Egypt? But as I said, we could take the case of France or the case of Greece also, or any case, but perhaps, or even in some Latin American countries, such as Brazil, for instance. Active minority had is living in a society which has been destroyed throughout 40 years. I'll speak later, perhaps, if we have to speak of long waves, of not neoliberal policy and glorious growth within neoliberal policies, the World Bank, blah, blah, and the European Commission, blah, blah, and so on, but lumpen development. That is, the official statistics says in Egypt that 60% of the Egyptian people are surviving in the non-informal sectors and so on and so forth. That was a strategy. We ought to know that the enemy has a strategy, which is called in that case development, but it's not development, it's lumpen development, the target of which being to prevent a country, a dangerous country like Egypt, to become a so-called emerging country, which could be competing in political sense, not competing necessarily only on trade. And that strategy was developed, this is why we should connect the problem of this distance between the results in electoral terms with the geostrategy. The three intimate allies, the US, Israel, and the Gulf countries, their major target since 40 years was to prevent a renaissance of Egypt. Egypt moving on, being up on its feet. And through a loop, financing a lumpen development. That financing of lumpen development with the money of the Gulf, with the support of the US aid, the moral support of the Europeans, and some money, of course, from them also, was financing that spiral down, a process of pauperization. And it is through this process of pauperization that the reactionary political Islam represented the Muslim Brotherhood could have an objective basis, because they are partners in that, they are financing this spiral of pauperization of surviving activities, and therefore they could have an easy electoral majority, which is reflecting exactly the opposite of what the gigantic popular movement was demanding. So we have to understand that now, I said, and I will not be as long, of course, I would just one sentence. I think there is a distance between the results, and many people in France who have voted for Hollande want much more than they know that they could expect from Hollande. And I, even if Syriza in Greece has been a very good advance, and I'm very happy of that. I'm sure that many of the Greeks who want more than what could come and has not come. But
what Syriza can offer.
The elections. Yes. Thank you. Elections are always giving a prime to conservative forces. Never forget that.